If you have a script running on an object, you'll often want to apply it to other similar objects. Right now, if I wanted to apply this same script to another value, I would have to copy and paste it on the other text object, then manually edit the script text. This is fine now, because this is a small script, and I wrote it, so I know what to change. But what if this was a 200-line script that someone else made? There is a better way. Let's start by adding a parameter to manage the set point of the script we created previously. Because Graphics Editor is a graphical interface, the best way to do this is with a new property. In the script object's properties, I'll right-click and add. I'll name the custom attribute setpoint and give it a value 100 for now. I could also leave it blank, forcing me or the next user to change it each time. While I'm here, I'll go ahead and name this object setpoint script. You'll see why in just a moment. Now for the script itself. Here, I want to extract the value of that property I just created. I'll start with the parent text element, evt.getCurrentTarget. Next, we need to navigate down to the script object. For this, we'll use a non-standard JavaScript function. Remember that the web HMI has its own library of functions in addition to the standard, and one of those is getChild. This function takes a string and returns the element whose name property matches that string. Fortunately, I already named this setpoint script. Now that I have the script object, I just need to extract the value of the custom attribute setpoint. Then replace the fixed value in the branch statement. Now you can see that I can change the custom property to modify the set point in the script. We're almost there. If I give this script to another user, they won't have to modify any JavaScript to change the set point that it uses. There is one last step to make this simple to reproduce, however. Let's turn our script into a snippet. Just like creating a custom component, I can drag my script into the snippets library and give it a name for reuse. To reproduce my text object, I'll create a new one, bind its content with a unique name, drag the snippet over it, and change the set point. But let's make this even more generic. Right now, it only works on text's stroke. But what if I wanted to change the fill color of a rectangle? I can even pass the target attribute to the script. Just like before, I'll add a new property called attribute. However, this looks a bit different in the properties pane. Graphics Editor recognizes the name attribute and automatically creates a drop-down menu of the parent element's properties. Similarly, if I wanted to parameterize a color, I could create a property called fill, and Graphics Editor will create a color picker. Back in the script, you can probably guess what I'm going to do. I'll read that new attribute into a variable called target. Then use that attribute to set below. I can now create my setpoint snippet. Finally, I'll create a rectangle this time. For this purpose, the rectangle itself isn't actually displaying the value. So when I add a binding, I won't give it an attribute to modify, just a custom name. I'll drag my snippet over the rectangle. Give it a set point. And verify its attribute is fill. You should be getting a feel for how we can create and reuse scripts to perform custom actions on a page. Before we get too far though, we want to minimize the impact of our scripts on the WebHMI client. Next, we'll move our script into the global context. Until then, thank you.